Ladies and gentlemen, our inductee, James Randall Jimmy Geiger. Cute little Jimmy, as a toddler, would grow up to be a fierce competitor. He once scored 42 points in a basketball game for Boaz High School. 50 years later, the 42 points are good enough for the second highest single game performance in Pirate basketball history. Jimmy Geiger and his classmate Roger Martin were starters as ninth graders for the Boaz Varsity Pirates. Front row, left to right, number 27, Roger Martin. Number 23, Jimmy Geiger. Number 24, Wayne Stanfill. Number 30, Billy Kittles. And number 25, Ken Chambers. Top row, left to right, number 31, Don Noel. Number 26, Eugene Salms. Number 29, Billy Arrington. Number 22, B. Langley. And last, without a uniform, Jimmy Brenly. Here the year before as eighth graders and his B varsity teammates. On the front row, left to right, number 15, Edwin Rush. Number 31, Jimmy Geiger. No number on, Crosby Reagan. Number 10, Billy Thompson. Number 12, Roger Martin. Number 34, Billy Arrington. Number 29, Thomas Hall. Number 23, Wayne Stanfill. And number 17, Donald Noel. Their senior season, 1955-56, Geiger and Martin were basketball co-captains. They didn't realize it at the time, but their lives would forever be closely connected as teammates, coaches, and friends. Geiger played for Marshall County Hall of Fame coach Emmett Plunkett's Boaz Cagers from 1953 through 56. Number 13, Roger Martin. Number 12, Jimmy Geiger. His senior year, the 6'3" Pirate pivot averaged 25 points while leading his team to the county championship and second place in the 8th district. Geiger sparked the team into the state tournament for the first time in 9 years and the third appearance in history. Despite a 58-48 first-round loss to Fayette, Jimmy was the real workhorse in the game, going at full speed throughout the game with the hope of keeping the Pirates in the official running for the state crown. Plunkett's Cagers ended the season with a 20-5 record. Front row, left to right, number 8, John Vickers, number 6, Philip Smith, number 7, Tommy Wilkerson, number 5, Bobby Wilson. On the back row, left to right, number 14, Jimmy Brenly, number 12, Jimmy Geiger, number 10, Donald Thomas, number 11, Gerald Noel, number 9, James Malone, number 13, Roger Martin. The Pirates relax before a big game. Jimmy is the fourth player from the left. Geiger played quarterback for Coach James Verguinen on the Boaz teams of 1954 and 55. He was one of the best punters in Marshall County with an average of 39.3 yards per kick. As quarterback on the football team, Geiger was joined by basketball buddies Roger Martin at running back and Gerald Noel at end. The three formed a lasting friendship. Number 23, Geiger, number 26, Noel, and number 27, Martin. As football players, Martin 27 and Geiger number 30. Here is Jimmy's senior picture. Jimmy was a member of the Future Farmers of America and the school choral group. He was best liked at Boaz High School. Best liked, Jimmy Geiger and Polly Bishop. The awards and recognition in high school basketball were 3 times All-County, 2 times All-District, 2 times All-Sand Mountain, 2 seasons as co-captain, most outstanding player of the 8th district, all-time individual scoring record Sand Mountain Basketball Tournament, North-South All-Star Game at Tuscaloosa, and a scholarship to the University of Tulsa. Here is one of the 3 all-county teams that he made, left to right. The first player is Cheryl Cook of Douglas, second is Wayne Warren of Douglas, number 3 is Bruce Wright of Albertville, the 4th player, Billy Charles Boulding of Gunnersville, 5th player, Walter Wood of Gunnersville, wearing number 4. Jones of A-Route is next. Jimmy Geiger is the 7th player from left to right. He is from Boaz. And the 8th player is Joe Doc Henson of DAR wearing number 19. And the 9th player, Thomas Franks of DAR wearing number 15. This was from 1954. After a year at Tulsa, Jimmy joined former Boaz players Donald Thomas, Gerald Noel, and Coach Emmett Plunkett at Snead College. Playing for his former Boaz coach, he earned Most Valuable Player at Snead, MVP Region 7 Tournament, and led Snead to the Region 7 Junior College Championship. The 1958 Parsons became the first Alabama Junior College team to play in the national tournament. They played three games, good enough for 10th in the nation, before being eliminated in the tournament at Hutchinson, Kansas. Left to right, number 14, Gene Norman, number 13, Jack Mooneyham, number 17, Paul Pritchett, number 4, Gerald Noel, number 8, Donald Thomas, number 12, Don Owens, number 15, Fred Bobo, number 16, Jimmy Geiger, number 7, Louis Mize, number 9 is Charles Heaton, number 11, Willard Townsend, number 6, Hugh Stewart, and on the front is manager James Malone and coach Emmett Plunkett. Following junior college, Jimmy was given the opportunity to finish his career with Nicholls State University. Geiger was listed in the Nicholls State University program as the best offensive rebound man on the squad. A tenacious driver and good jump shooter makes him a constant threat. Coach Geiger made the scene in 1962 as the Boaz Junior High basketball and football coach. Roger Martin had just finished up at Auburn and joined him as an assistant. Roger remained at Boaz as an educator for the next 30 years. Geiger left Boaz to become the head basketball coach at Geraldine. After a short tenure at Geraldine, he returned to Boaz, where he later became a varsity head basketball coach and an assistant in football. Coach Geiger, he can't believe the call. He says, "I've just got to walk away." Coach Geiger and some of his award winners. Left to right, Coach Geiger, Joe Rhines, a junior, the most spirited award winner, and Terry Frazier, a junior, best offensive player. Not shown, Dwayne Dyer, best defensive player. The late Johnny Wallace, an upperclassman and a Pirate cager, once told Gerald Noel, when Jimmy joined the varsity, he was the best player on the team, even as a freshman. In the 1970s, Geiger moved from coaching into the business world. He continued to stay close to the sport that he loved by officiating high school basketball. And then suddenly, the Boaz community and Marshall County were shocked and saddened when the tall, handsome athlete's heart stopped at age 43. Tonight, his legacy joins his late brother-in-law, Travis Hunt, and all of the other greats in the history of Marshall County sports. Ladies and gentlemen, our inductee, James Randall Jimmy Geiger.
On behalf of Jimmy and Joanne and his sister and all the family members and all the teammates and just good friends, we want to thank the board and the selection committee for making this selection. We think Jimmy deserved it. He was a heck of a basketball player. I might tell you one little story. He mentioned my wife and I were in Huntsville several years ago. Had breakfast, and in walked this guy, 6'4", 6'5", and I recognized him as Don Mincher. And I know some of you know who I'm talking about. And if you don't, Don Mincher was a all-state basketball player over at Butler High School in the early 50s, mid-50s, I guess. And he was a all-state, all-American, all-everything you could get in baseball. He went on and played in major leagues, came back to Huntsville and managed the Huntsville Stars. And I think he finally wound up maybe owner or half owner of Huntsville Stars. So anyway, I told my wife, I said, "I'm gonna go back and speak to him." And I went back and I said, "You don't remember me, but I bet you'll remember a night in about 1956 over at Crossville, Alabama." At that time, Crossville had just built a new gym. And the old 8th district was divided into two parts, the eastern part and the western part. Well, we at Boaz had went out in the eastern part, and Butler, which was one of the biggest schools in the state at the time, won in the western part. And but when we played at Crossville, we won. We beat Butler. And so I asked Mincher if he remembered that night over in Crossville, and he said his very words were, "Yes, I do," he said. "I got in foul trouble early, and I couldn't guard that old boy all night long." And that old boy was Jimmy Geiger, and that night was the night he scored 42 points against Butler, one of the best teams in the state and one of the best ball players in the state, probably. So it was a good time for us. But again, that was 50 years ago, I don't know where the 50 years went, but they're gone. And again, we want to thank the board and the selection committee and everybody concerned with the selection. Thanks.
I just want to say thank you, and I could tell a few stories, but I better not because I might tell the wrong one. But Jimmy was a gifted athlete and a good friend. Thank you.